Wow. A lot of burnt stuff. It's weird because it's kind of in like little patches too. Mm-hmm. Except up there, it's like all burnt.
Oh, wow.
Here too.
Mm-hmm. They jumped
over the road. That's crazy. Yeah, I think redwood trees are pretty good when it comes to this.
I see the structure survive, but then look back there. It looks like that.
And somehow it didn't get all this.
Yeah.
Like garden-y thing.
All around it, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, like how did these vineyards stay safe when this whole area is burnt?
For some reason, the vineyards have a little moisture or something. It's weird.
Well, the vineyards do take all the water from the ground.
See, like there's this, and then there's this Cal Fire.
So that's safe.
But then look, right next to Cal Fire, this apartment.
That is weird.
Well, this is a field. There's a garden over here that thing that burnt down.
Burnt up and burnt down.
So this is where the brewery was.
It's still preserved.
Here's this part of the thing.
Yeah. Wow, all of these structures. Oh wow, especially this one.
I think they were building a new house here or something. Or they had built a new house here. I don't go to the Santa Rosa that much. But...
a lot of trees chopped up too. Right across the street, that house is fine.
Okay.
There's a bathtub.
I know, so sad. Red Milner used to live here on this street. Or was he on Bonnie? I don't remember, but he was here.
How does that grass not get burnt, but the whole house does? The washer and dryer right there. Their fence even got burned, but...
I know. That's...
yeah, this is definitely the worst area, I feel like. As far as most number, biggest number of houses destroyed in a row.
Yeah. Fountain Grove and Coffee Park are the worst in San Francisco.
Yeah. Staircase.
I know. Weirdo.
Yeah.
It's like a hazmat team here.
Yeah. They had old gas pumps there.
That's where Cassie's sister,